let's end class today by introducing the Runge-Kutta 4 method, order 4 method, to our example, trying to apply these equations, first maybe even a little bit by hand, and then with the computer. Our IVP is the same IVP as before. Dy dt equals f of ty, which for our example is 12 minus 4y over 10 plus 2t. Initial condition y of 0 equals 200. The a, the starting value of t is 0. The alpha, the starting value of y is 200. We're trying to apply this algorithm that you see here to approximate the solution of the differential equation. And we want to apply the algorithm ultimately more than just once. This would be, what you see here would be one step of the Runge-Kutta method. We want to apply it over and over again. Like if h is 0.1, we want to apply it 450 times, of course, using a computer. But let's see if we can do one step of this by hand. Going back to our old friends, say h is 0.1. And while we try to apply it, let's see if we can get a little intuition about what's going on. What's really going on with this method geometrically, instead of trying to use something like Taylor's theorem or something. Geometrically, what's going on? So according to this method, we start by letting W0 be alpha, 200 in this case. Big picture, what looks like it's going on here? These k's, you can see, are values found by taking h, the step size, and multiplying by values of f. Values of f, we know, represent slopes in the slope field. If you multiply such slopes by a step size, it's going to give you a change in y, right? Step size h times a slope gives you an approximate change in y, at least along some tangent line to a solution curve somewhere. What's this doing? Taking the previous value of w and adding 1/6 times that. What's this thing? That's essentially a weighted average, isn't it? A weighted average of the k's, where we're giving double the weights to k2 and k3 compared to k1 and k4. You're essentially adding 6 numbers here. K1 once, k2 twice, k3 twice, k4 once, dividing by how many numbers there are, 6. It's a weighted average of those numbers. A weighted average is these changes in y's, these approximations to changes in solution values. That's getting added to the previous value of w to get the new value of w. That's what's going on. I'll try to draw a little picture as well. Let's go ahead and compute it though. K1 evidently should be h times f of 0, 200. So that's 0.1 times f of 0, 200. Okay, we'll have to use Mathematica or a calculator sum here. Since I've got the function plugged into Mathematica, that'll be a bit more convenient. Again, the function is f of ty or f of tw if you prefer. F of 0, 200, that's the slope in the slope field at the initial condition. It's negative 68. Multiply it by 0.1, you get negative 6.8. This is negative 6.8. That could be thought of as an approximation to the change in your solution as t increases from 0 to 0.1. But you can compute other approximations to the change in solution. The next K2 is another approximation to the change in the value of the solution as t increases from 0 to 0.1. It's found by computing h times f of, what's that? Ti plus h over 2 plus comma wi plus 1/2 k1. So instead of evaluating at 0, we evaluate at 0.1 divided by 2, 0.05, half a step effectively. And here, not at 200, but 200 plus 1/2 K1. What a weird thing to evaluate it at. What's going on here? And yes, this is point one here. And the slope field. At the point 0, 200, we saw that the slope mark drawn there should have slope negative 68. Slope equals negative 68. Your true solution at time equals zero has a tangent line with a slope of negative 68. And K1 then approximates the change in the solution by estimating this distance here to be 6.8. Negative 68 times 0.1 is negative 6.8. To bring you down to this point, 0.1 comma 200 minus 6.8 would be 193.2. The change K1 is negative 6.8. In figuring out K2, this point that you're plugging into F is really the second coordinate, or the coordinates of this point halfway along that line. This simplifies to 200 minus 3.4, 197.6. The coordinates of that point are 0.05, 197.6. We're plugging that point into F and finding the slope there and multiplying times 0.1. What's the slope there? I'm guessing it's a little bit bigger, a little closer to zero. Slope equals F of this thing. It's still negative, I imagine, but a little closer to zero. Let's go ahead and see what it is. F of 0.05, 197.6.
It's 196.
Is it 196.6? Thank you. 2.4, yeah, 196.6. That's the danger of doing things in your head. Negative 65.8614. So this becomes 0.1 times negative 65.8614. That'll be negative 6.58614. Effectively, we're using that slope, the negative 65.8614, at this point, and kind of like translating it back up there. It's not the true tangent line up here, but it's like we're using it to estimate K2. Is that a good idea? Evidently it is. We're using the slope at this point to estimate the change in Y from this point. It's all part of a weighted average though still. K3 is H times F of Ti plus H over 2, so that'll be 0.05 again. Wi plus 1/2 K2, the previous K2 we just found. 200 plus 1/2 times, we just found this K2 to be negative 6.58614. So it's like we're using, it's like we're now using this red line and following it for half a unit and using the slope there as well. get another line and follow that line 0.1 units to the right. You get another estimate for the change in y. Once again, this is 0.1. Okay, so I'll do it this way in Mathematica. Oops. Yeah, and I wanted to do this. Ah. I guess I already did that. F of 0.05, comma, 200, I'll type it in as 200 plus 1/2 times negative 6.58614. That's the slope we use, but then we multiply by 0.1 again. That's K3, 6.59037. Negative 6.59037. Finally, K4 is that F of, it'll be H times F of 0.1 now, not 0.05, comma WI 200 plus K3. And it's not 1/2 K3, but K3 itself. K3 is the negative 6.59037. This should still be something, you know, a negative 6.5 something probably. 0.1 times F of 0.1 comma 200 minus 6.59037. Yep, same kind of ballpark. Now we got to do the weighted average of these things. About to do that right there. Maybe I want to give these things names in Mathematica. This is K1. This is K2. This is K3. This is K4. I do the weighted average K1 plus 2K2 plus 2K3 plus K4 divided by 6. That's what gets added to 200 to get my approximation to the solution at time equals 0.1. How does this compare with phi of 0.1? It's, wow, very good. Okay, how do you implement this faster? I got this code from another differential equations book that I use called Differential Equations by Blanchard, Devaney, and Hall. It's this code here in this notebook, which I will post on Moodle. It's applied to a different example. But let's apply it to our example. So I'm going to copy and paste the basic code is what you see here. This is using a Mathematica command called module, which effectively is a little program. The way you apply this is you also use nestList to get runga-kutta results. You're effectively using nestList on this function, runga-kutta step. You're doing those steps over and over again. You put your right-hand side of your differential equation here, so that for us, that's f of ty. You put your initial condition here, so for us, that's 0, 200. And number of steps here, we're using h as 0.1 again, so we do 450 steps again. Why is there a sharp or a pound symbol there and an and there? I don't want to go into details, but this is Mathematica's way of representing something called a pure function. I don't want to explain what that is, but this is a way to get nestless to act on this runga-kutta step. The pound symbol is in place of the initial condition, effectively, which also goes here. Should work. And after 45 minutes, it is giving us our old friend 201.8. But it's more accurate in between as well, including in the very first step. Much more accurate.